Hello. In this lesson, we're going to learn about campaign site sections, which are the core building blocks for your pages. Inside our site editor, we're looking at a live editable preview of our site. In the editor top bar, we can access pages of our site and configure universal settings like our site's theme, giving form, and overall settings. We learn all about these details in another lesson. Today, we're going to jump right into the page and learn about sections. Sections are full-width containers that host content blocks on your page. Your page can contain many sections. When you hover over a section, you'll see a blue border around the entire section, letting you know the items that will be impacted when you edit the section settings. Inside the section are content blocks. You can click directly into a content block to edit its contents. We'll discuss content blocks later in this lesson. Before we move on, it's good to know a few more things about sections. First, there are many types of sections. At the top of our page, we're looking at a section that includes a large banner and a progress bar. Below that, a section that hosts a recent donor feed, and below that are sections that highlight content and call to action buttons in various layouts. Second, you can add or remove sections to your page. To add a new section to your page, hover right above where you'd like to add a new section and click the plus sign. This is your section library. It's a collection of helpful pre-built content layouts that will help you easily build engaging fundraising pages. For text sections, you can choose from a variety of content layouts and column options. As you become more familiar with Funraise's sections, you'll realize that these text sections are really just unique configurations of the same text section. These options are just providing pre-built layouts to jumpstart your designs. Later in this video, we'll learn about section columns and everything will come full circle. But for now, let's move on to see other section options. Image sections provide helpful layouts for sections that feature large or small images, and split layouts for images and text. Video sections provide a few helpful layouts for videos. Fundraising sections will be available on pages that have a goal, like your homepage, fundraiser pages, or team pages. Here on the homepage, we can add a top bar section that includes a progress bar. We can also add an isolated progress bar and a section that includes a feed of recent donations. And finally, developers can add an HTML container to the body of the page to completely customize a section's contents. It's good for developers to know that scripts placed into the HTML section of a page body will not execute. To execute a function, you'll need to add scripts to your site's header code injection, which is accessible from settings. All right, let's pick one of these options and learn more about how sections work. Great, we've just added a new section. And we can keep on going adding sections. You've got full control. But let's dig into this particular section. First, let's learn about the section's overall settings, which appear at the top right of the section. You can delete a section by clicking the trash can icon. You can control the section's theme settings by clicking on the palette icon. Here, you can toggle through your site's design themes. And remember, these three themes are customized in your site's universal theme settings, which is accessible in the editor top bar. We cover these themes in detail in another video. For now, we'll just need to know that these sections can access the themes here, and that section content blocks can also access these themes, which we'll play with later in this video. And finally, in overall section controls, we can manage the format and background for this section. Let's learn about the section background first. We can apply no background, which just means that the section will take the background color from the theme, or we can apply an image to the background. When using a background image, you can also align the image in the container. It's important to note here that background images are exactly that. They're meant to be in the background, as a design element, behind your content. Background images are not content and should not contain text that is meant to be read by the viewer. This is particularly important for your site's accessibility, but also important because background images are resized based on a viewer's screen size. It's common for large parts of a background image to be cut off depending on the viewer's screen size. This is because the background image will always be resized to fill the entire height and width of the section, which are based on the viewer's device. If you are adding a poster type image that contains important text, you'll want to add a new section with a single column image. This will enable you to display the image as content and not background, which means the image will always appear on full on any screen size. But remember, when you only display important text in an image, it reduces the accessibility of your site for users with screen readers. All right, and finally in background options, we can set a video for a section background. This option is a bit more advanced. Adding videos to backgrounds of websites is very possible, but takes a lot of consideration for both the movement on screen and the size of the file being loaded. First, the basics. You'll need to provide a direct link to the video file. At the time of this recording, YouTube or Vimeo links cannot be used for a video background. A direct link to the video file is something your web developer can assist you with. Or, quick tip, if you're using a website builder like WordPress or Squarespace, you can upload files and access a direct link from there. Background videos are best when they are a very short, like 10 seconds, looping video with very subtle movement on the screen, similar to what you're seeing here. It's also important to compress your video. Loading a large video file can significantly impact your page performance. It's best to work with a web developer to provide a video file link using best practices. And as a final note on videos, video backgrounds will not display on a mobile device. Instead, your section will fall back to a static image if it's provided. So even if you're using a video background, you'll also want to load a static image for your background as the mobile fallback. And then be sure to flip back into video mode. Next, let's look at the section's overall format settings. Here, you can set the width and height of your sections. You can select small, medium, or large, or set a custom width, and the same options for your height. In most cases, you'll probably want to use a medium height setting. Next up is section grids. Grids bring a level of sophistication and improved user experience to your layouts. Right now, our section has one column, so it has one content block. Here, we can add up to 4 columns and 12 items, or 12 content blocks. Okay, now we've got 3 columns and 3 items. Great. Now, we can customize these content blocks. One excellent use case for a grid section is a call to action area with specific donation amounts. So let's build that quickly as an example. We'll just customize the header and text for this column, and add a donation button to make this column actionable. When adding a donation button to your sections, you can also set the default amount that your donation button will open with, which is exactly what we want to do for this section. Next, a quick tip. I can repeat that design process over for each column, or it can remove these columns and then add them again. This is a quick way to duplicate a column layout to other columns, because when you add a column, it will copy the design of its previous neighbor. Awesome! Now we've got 3 columns we just need to slightly customize. And as easy as that, we've built a custom donation section that we can continue to configure as our campaign strategy calls for. Okay, one more cool thing while we're here. Each section content block can use a specific theme variation. This is an additional way to highlight your content. To have a content block use a theme color, you'll first need to raise the surface. This means placing the content inside a card, which is a common modern design element. In most cases, raising surfaces will not be necessary. Good design uses the least amount of stuff to communicate the most amount of stuff. But in this case, it provides some nice additional structure and provides an option to specifically feature one of these impact amounts. For example, we can now select a different theme for this card to visually differentiate a preferred giving option for our site visitors. Alrighty, now you're an expert on campaign site sections. Have fun!